knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we began discussing the genus Homo by introducing the first species of the genus. Moving forward chronologically, Homo erectus is one of the most variable hominins there is, if we are assessing it sensu lato. Sensu lato is the term that refers to a species' broadest definition, including myriad specimens others may think should be their own species. Sensu stricto refers to a species when only universal or near-universal specimens are included. Homo erectus sensu lato is composed of some specimens that are very old and basal-looking, and others are much younger and more derived, with localities all around the world. This, and the fact that the specimens are found across nearly 2 million years of time, has led some paleoanthropologists to argue that the species should be split into at least three groups: Homo erectus, Homo ergaster, and Homo georgicus. The oldest specimen we know of that is assigned to Homo erectus is a skull fragment, specifically an occipital bone, from East Turkana in Kenya. This fragment has been given a maximum age of 1.9 million years ago, chronologically just a bit younger than the date thought for Homo erectus's exodus out of Africa. Homo erectus is the first hominin known to leave the continent, thought to have done so around 2 million years ago before eventually making its way to Europe, Asia, and Oceania. For this reason, Homo erectus is sometimes considered in its geographic context. The members of the proposed Homo georgicus are found exclusively in Dmanisi, Georgia, and date to an age of 1.85 to 1.77 million years ago. These apes are best known from five exceptional skulls, and are collectively known as the Dmanisi hominins. The skulls exhibit a wide range of morphologies in the brain case and in the face, despite coming from the same relatively short time frame. Skull 5 is extremely basal, sporting a 546 cubic centimeter brain case and prominent prognathism. Skulls 4 to 2 range from 600 to 650 cubic centimeters, with one individual having large canines. Skull 1 has a brain case of 775 cc's, the largest of the group, although its incomplete nature leaves the facial morphology to be determined. For this reason, some paleoanthropologists have suggested that the Dmanisi hominins represent more than one species, with others proposing a single species with marked sexual dimorphism and age-related differences. The most recent work from 2017 has proposed that the more basal of the skulls share numerous characteristics with Homo habilis, while the more derived skulls appear more similar to Homo ergaster, or African Homo erectus. They argue that these skulls are effectively a snapshot of a species in transition, which, regardless of how we classify them, they very clearly are. After around 100,000 years, at 1.6 million years ago, Homo erectus sensu lato would be found with brains reaching over 800 cc's, far off in Java, in China, and also back in Africa. Brain case size would continue to grow in all localities where Homo erectus is found, reaching as high as slightly over 1,200 cc's, but averaging 1,000 cc's when all specimens are considered. In addition to the brain case size increasing, Homo erectus sees the continued flattening of the face, thickening of the cranial vault, and the arrival of the nasal bones. The latter indicates that Homo erectus may have been the first hominin with an external nose, like what we see in modern humans. The palate is continuing towards the more parabolic shape seen in modern humans, but this hominin generally has heavy brow ridges and a more sloping forehead. The body of Homo erectus is similar to modern humans, and it is proposed to have been capable of long-distance running, much as we are. This, in addition to the increasing brain case size and presence of large game in assemblages, indicates Homo erectus was consuming meat from game it actively hunted. This meat was in addition to an enormous variety of vegetables and fruits. Around 800,000 years ago, both fish and vegetables can be found with chemical signatures indicative of cooking. This, of course, means Homo erectus, at least the more recent populations, was capable of utilizing fire. This is unsurprising given its extensive toolkit throughout the species' lifespan. Homo erectus invented the Acheulean tool technology, which likely helped make it such a prolific hunter. Javan populations additionally used seashells as tools, and boreholes in some shells may indicate their use in jewelry, suggesting they could also use knots. Homo erectus is argued to have worn clothes for a very interesting reason. Modern humans have two forms of lice, head lice and pubic lice. The divergence date for these lice is around 170,000 years ago, well after hominins left Africa and passed through extremely cold climates. This has been used as an argument that clothes were invented as a sort of necessity for the exodus of Homo erectus out of Africa. This hominin has been argued by some to have been seafaring as well, given it is found in Java well over a million years ago when a land bridge was not present. The reason for Homo erectus's out-of-Africa event should be clear at this point. This species had a degree of environmental dominance. It was capable of utilizing fire and clothes to keep warm in hostile climates, tools to kill and cut up food, and potentially vessels to cross water bodies. Its brain was large and growing, meaning this hominin would have been able to plan around water availability and even carry its water with it. This facilitated the hominin's movement as it was no longer tied to one spot. Socially, Homo erectus represents another large milestone. Sexual dimorphism is thought to be low, indicating possible pair bonds like modern human monogamy. Art has been argued in the form of hash marks on seashells as well. Perhaps most importantly, Homo erectus had extensive altruistic tendencies very early in its tenure, all the way back at the Dominici specimens. Skull 4 has no teeth, and the sockets have grown closed. This means the individual survived well after its teeth and its ability to chew had gone. Someone had to have chewed or ground up their food for them, meaning Homo erectus, or Homo georgicus, was caring for its sick as long ago as 1.8 million years. This is hallmark human behavior, and in a population with brain cases as low as 546 cc's. Homo erectus would continue to evolve in all its localities. In Africa, we see Homo ergaster, which is African Homo erectus sensu lato. KNMWT-15000 is a full skeleton from 1.5 million years ago, known as the Turkana boy. His body is very familiar, but his brain would have been around 880 cc's. In Java, Sangiran 38 shows up with 850 cc's around the same time. The picture here seems to suggest that various populations of Homo erectus sensu lato emerged at different time periods, spreading out into the world to become Homo erectus sensu stricto in Asia and Homo ergaster or African Homo erectus on the African continent. Humans unequivocally descend from the African lineage, which is argued to have gone through another few species before leading to Homo sapiens. However, Asian Homo erectus persisted in China until a mere 50,000 years ago, sharing the world with our own species for 250,000 years. Let's move forward and continue examining genus Homo.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.